morning, everybody. No breakfast. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, sir.
Now I think we have heard. Thank you very much. Respected Principal sir, Reverend Plausido Perrar sir, well-wisher and a good friend now, Mr. Linson sir, and your Hindi madam, Hindi teacher, Poornima ji, who brought all of us together. Faculties, dear student boys and girls, today is a great day, at least for me. And when I join with you, so the day becomes very great, because I have been coming to Goa. I attended many conferences here, but never had an opportunity to meet any student here. Though I worked all over the country, I don't know how I missed this beautiful state. So thank you very much for extending the invitation and allowing me to give my maiden motivational lecture here in Goa. Thank you. When I start talking to you about motivation, motivation is a very, very simple word. But actually, it can motivate a person to a great extent. We may not know that at times all human beings go through a phase called depression. That is mostly psychological depressions, and due to too much stress that goes around in the society with us. For you children, the stress may be of different type. Maybe your stress for getting good marks, maybe for competing with your fellow students, and maybe that you have some pressure, maybe economically, or maybe from the family, or sometimes from the parents. So these are the stress and pressure you go through in your life, and they do create an impact in your performance. What is life? Life is very simple. You are here, and you will be going from here. The span that is given to you approximately is 100 years. If you extend it by another 10, 15 years, excellent. But these 100 years, 12 years you lose. Very young, very small, you call it childish age, where no responsibility, good or bad, we enjoy. The last 12 years, my age, now I am 65. So 65 to, you know, you can just imagine from 60 to another 12, 15 years, we will become too old, and though mind will be working, we will not be able to do anything. Similarly with every human being. So the fag end of 12 to 10 years and the beginning of the 10 to 12 years, these two are the time which our performance do not matter much. But our performance matters much once we enter into that 30. That is the most dangerous age for any human being. That is called teenage. Once you enter that age, you enter into a situation from where whatever you do will no more be implications of any other individual. Initially, what you do? A for? Tell me. A for? Alphabetically, A for what? What did you say? A for? Apple. My God, you can't say ant? No aeroplane? Now what is this? This is what I want to now talk to you. Tell me, G for? B for? B for? See, the difference is not coming. They all should have been a very confused voice. Somebody should have said ball, somebody should have said bat, somebody should have said bag, somebody should have said something else. When you are not differing with each other to the very word that alphabetically comes in front of you as B for not bat, it can be bat. It can be a bug. When you are not different, that means you are duplicating. When you are duplicating, you are still below the required age of understanding that you have to excel. You have to differ. You have to prove your performance better. That is the point. Are you getting me? Answer me.
Yes.
Are you understanding me?
Yes.
Otherwise, no point. I'm just standing like a cinema actor in the screen, you know. Cinema is good or not, only you decide. Next day, nobody comes to the hall. But here it's interactive. So, the duplication stops at the age of 12. But when it is not stopping, then you have to question yourself. Then why are you doing what Sheila is doing, or what Sailaja is doing, or Mary is doing? You need not do that. You got to be different. And our principal sir will agree that earlier days of education was very different from the days we are today going through. Earlier education was, if you write what is written in the book, then the marks are automatically reduced to only 6 out of 10. 60 T10. Because it's like a parrot. You know, we teach parrot so many things. Some fellow was teaching parrot Rama Rama Rama. Okay, fine. The parrot was telling everybody come to his home, he introduces himself, yeah, Rama Rama Rama, both the parrot, both great. Ultimately, what happened? An idiot like me entered the house. So he told, yeah, there are parrot, sir, yeah, Rama Bolta. I took out a small duplicate snake, a replica of a snake, and showed the parrot. Immediately said, can. See, that the moment the conscious arose that he is no more in a position to defend himself, he realized that he has to come back to his original, call his people, his friends. They will not listen to the language of Rama. Suppose we humans start barking like a dog, who will get attracted? Few around us may clap and few say, hello. But suppose we are not duplicated and we use our mind and start thinking and innovating, then we are growing. That's the beginning of excelling. That is the beginning of your first step towards growth. So today, when I am talking to you, I have to take you to a little bit of background, to the days of Adam and Eve. They were the first human being. I will not take the spiritual metaphor, I will take the general metaphor. They were the first two human beings who came to this world, the first man and the first woman. Then what happened next? They were in a forest. They lived with animals. So we'll take that. We'll not take the divine side of it, we'll come to the other side of it. So in during that phase, what happens? Sometimes they don't get food because the lion is more powerful. You know, at 3 years, a tiger, a small cub, if he gives a stroke on anybody's face, it is 3 ton weight. 3 ton. If you imagine just if it is a 5 years old, it can just smash a muscle in one stroke. So that's the power they have, animals. So the muscle power was so dominating during that time, then the man who was also a part of mammal family, helplessly watching, he cannot kill anybody. He used to eat small things and leave. That's how the vegetarian and the non-vegetarian both attended to his life. Because vegetarian is nothing, he gets, he picks up some fruits and eat. And when he really gets something to kill and eat it, then he enjoys. But before he eats also, he was always in trouble. Because any other big animal can come and push him out or eat him too. So that's the time. There was no creator of anything other than the universal truth, the God. He is the one who gave the man the brain. You agree? From nothing, no family, no home to stay, no place to sleep, nothing is there with them. At that point of time, they started thinking what to do, how to do, so that they lead a better life than eating the leftover of these animals. They were feeling so painful. They were the first humans who laid the foundation of a civilized society which you and me are enjoying today. Look at their motivation. What was their motivation? Their motivation of belief. They believed themselves. And that belief made them pro. Investigate. Go around and understand things. Finding ways always. And one day, they could discover something fantastic. Can you tell me what they discovered first? I want a voice. What they discovered, what is the human's first discovery? Girls? tell me loudly why you are hesitating. Come out. The fire was the first discovery. And when they realized this fire is feared by the animals. And that's a point they differed from the manual group and made their individual identity. Whoever comes near them, they started showing fire. So animals started dispersing. Then they realized that they had some power in them. And from there, they planned weapons after weapon, how to kill them, and then started what they like to eat, how to stay, then covered their body with leaves, then taken out the skin of the animals, covered themselves, developed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They got stuck. They got stuck. Why they got stuck? They needed some scientific proof. At that point of time, this country where you stand today, all of us, all across religion, caste, creed, language, everything, we have nothing here. Commonly we are only human beings and they were only the human being. Later everything emerged. So what was the situation? In that situation, there was only one challenge in front of them. To make their life better. Better than the animal. So their every step towards growth started. And fantastic things happened in their life. You know, they went on to conquer. See, they conquered earth. They conquered air. Today you fly. I came yesterday 15 minutes from Bangalore to here. 15 minutes. And my colleague Prakash came in 12 hours by bus. Earlier people used to walk from Bangalore to Goa, means how much time they will take? Can you imagine? Can you imagine? They may have to travel 25, 30, 40 days. So situation has changed. The human discovered their best of their ability because they had that thinking faculty. What is their thinking faculty inside? This gave them the opportunity to grow. That was their motivation. That was the greatest motivation to make themselves comfortable. Today we have air conditioners, we have such nice speakers and various other systems we enjoy, the digital combination we enjoy, and here he's keeping a beautiful keyboard. These were all not there. There used to be a man who used to just look at the nature and say, oh, that is a song. Yeah. Then somebody told you, oh, so then he said, no. Then the rhythm started. The rhythm was existing. Please understand something beautiful here. There is nothing that human has invented till date in this planet Earth. Not a single invention takes place. Everything is a discovery which God has already created. So, I am trying to connect to you something. They stopped at 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, buckle my shoe. Right? Tell me, 1, 2? I will not leave you. 1, 2? No. Something wrong with you. Rain is outside, not inside. 1, 2. 3, 4. 5, 6. 7, 8. But you know, the world stopped at 9. They never knew the gym. The greatest motivation came to the world when the greatest Indian scientist Acharya told them, 1, 2, buckle my shoe, you are there only. You can't move forward. Here I am giving you zero. The multiplication, the infinity he gave. So a greatest discovery took place on planet Earth. And that discovery happened in this part of the world. So we naturally belong to this country, we will take the credit for it. If suppose somebody says that Glenn McGrath from Australia is a good fast bowler, they take the credit, we take the credit. Humne zero diya, poore duniya. So everybody was claiming hero shape without being hero. We gave them zero, they became the hero. So Indians are not zero. It is the ability of multiplying from 1 to 100. Though individually 0 looks nothing. Right? But without 0, you cannot make a number multiply. So it is the number of 0 that makes number of heroes. So a very highly populated country like ours, 127 crores population. And you know something very surprising? The only country in the world today very young. The age group is below 35 years. Extraordinarily young, super, everyone he looks at, full of energy, full of pride, full of enthusiasm, and want to do something, want to do some great performance in life. What motivates you? Belief in yourself. That first man believed. He changed his life from nothing to something, and from something to everything. If he would have not thought that, and he would have not believed himself that he can fight those muscle power of animals, he can fight with all those things, you know, that exist in his skin, he would have not conquered those things. He believed himself. Today my topic is believe yourself. What is believe yourself? Believe in yourself what it does. Somebody comes and tells you, supposing you take a decision that you just tomorrow want to manufacture a submarine which can fly and which can also, you know, can have a non-human apparatus, and also it can just stand erect on a sky and still function as a, what you call, space station. You are trying to think like that. A submarine which will be like a space station, and it can also, you know, fly from one place to another place, and when necessary comes, it can also drive on the road. So this is your thinking. Now when you think like that, it is called imagination. Am I right? What it is called? Imagination. When something you imagine, or something you think, you say, hey, this fellow is only dreaming. He does all daydreaming. So people come with all negative perception. Arre, ye kuch nahi hai, ye hota nahi hai, it's not happening. You are in India, wasting your time, you better go and study. So from parents to the peers, that is our colleagues, our fellow human, everybody will come with all negative stories. And they will start telling you how a person like you wasted the time. They will tell you story after story to demotivate you. But I can tell you a small story on that, what a belief can make a difference. A small story that is in the name of a great American businessman, Rockefeller, John Rockefeller. John Rockefeller, one of the richest businessmen, now everybody says in the USA he's a Bill Gates or the saint of Omaha, Warren Buffett. But this person, Rockefeller, he is the one who made that Rockefeller Foundation where you have the Liberty Isles. That is the great Statue of Liberty standing there. He is the person who is the chairman for that. He is the one who did all that hard work for that. So, such a great genius businessman. A story is coined on his name. You see the story on belief yourself. There was a human being, like any one of us. He used to do some business. For 10, 15 years he did his business. And anyone does business or any job or anything, it's only to earn money, take care of his family and lead a comfortable life. This man was also doing that. But somehow the luck didn't favor him and his business ended up in huge loss. And he fell in the debt trap. And everybody, morning to evening, was knocking at his door to ask the money to be repaid. He was so upset and tensed. He didn't know what to do. And one day he just walked out from his home and endlessly walking to a place where he don't know where he is leading to, where this road will lead to. But ultimately he comes to a place where it looks like a beautiful garden. So he just came inside the garden and he saw a nice serene atmosphere. He just sat in a corner, there was a small bench. He sat there. And regretting for having done a business, he thought, I could have been a small employee, I would have not at least landed into debt trap. What will happen to my children? What will happen to my wife? All this was his worry, and tears were rolling out of his eyes. And you know, when a man is in pain, he is in pain. And he only knows that at that time he is the most depressed personality. He lost confidence in himself. He lost belief in himself. Everything negative that was happening to him at that point of time. Then suddenly, he saw an old man, very old man, walking towards him. He came there. Why are you so sad? He says, what to tell old man? You are an old man, I don't want to disturb you by telling my pain. He says, no, don't worry about me. Just tell me what's your problem. He sat next to him, put the hand on his shoulder, and told this businessman who was having so much pain, don't worry. You tell me first your problem. Then he told his entire problem, that my total debt trap is 50 lakhs of rupees today. 50 lakhs of rupees. And these 50 lakhs of rupees, if I don't pay, they will literally see to it that I do not exist anymore. What about my family if something happens to me? I feel like committing suicide, but it stops me from committing suicide because I just think about my family, my children. So this is my pain. Then he says, beautiful. You don't have to worry about it. That man put right hand in his trousers pocket, removed a checkbook. And he just signed, wrote some things there and gave to him. That man saw the check. It's 50 lakhs. He says, 50 lakhs? And the person who signed it, John Rockefeller. You're John Rockefeller? Who, my God, can I believe this? I mean, it was a rich man standing next to me. Said, I have the check. Next year, same time, we'll meet here. Same place. And you return my money. Now go back confidently and ensure that you don't live a life of depression. This man took the check, thanked him, and walks back. Literally runs back to his home and presents the check in his whatever that, you know, safe locker. And sits down quietly and asks his wife, can you get me a cup of tea? She was surprised to see this depressed man looking little energetic and quite confident. He says, just get me a tea, I'll tell you something. All our problems are solved, my dear wife. You don't have to worry. God has blessed us. A divine miracle took place in my life. I met John Rockefeller. And he sorted out all my problems. He didn't tell what exactly happened, transparent between them, but my all problems were solved. From today onwards, I am back to my business. And he went, sat in his office, started his work again. Can you believe he took a decision in the office that this check he will only encash if everything he is not able to sort out. So he kept the check. Now he is very confident that 50 lakhs is lying in his locker and he is a man who can do wonders now. And he started working on his confidence, and within 6 months he turned his business upside down and from downside up, and everything went into normal gear, and he cleared all debts. Business started roaring and roaring and roaring. And every Sunday he used to be at home, open the locker, look at the check, again keep it there. He never encashed it. He only put his own efforts and went on working. He took a positive stand that I am not going to encash check unless I want it. And look at that. After 1 year, the time has come to meet again John Rockefeller. So he takes the check, nicely makes a gift pack and goes to the same space. And he sits half an hour in advance in the bench and highly jubilant, highly energetic and full of pride. And then happens a small miracle. Again that old man walks in. He says, how are you? He says, you are just a god for me. You changed my life. I have come out of my all problems. My family is happy. I am happy. I have brought your money back to you. I am just giving you. That gift back, Rockefeller opens. Supposed to be Rockefeller, that old man. So he opens and sees the check as it is. He said, you are returning my check. You didn't encash it also. He said, I didn't encash. What does this story tell us? Can you tell me? I want second from you, please. I want you now. I have a very serious interaction. Please come. Tell me what is it.
To believe in yourself and have the confidence that you can do anything.
All right. What did the check play the role here?
To give him the confidence that I have the support.
But was it there or not? Because he didn't encash the check. He didn't encash. It was lying with him. Okay, thank you. Sit down. Anybody from there? Second from that side. Please. Please get it. Hello. Why? Ye camera in every state I go, I find change your anybody else? What do you understand from the story? Please. Yeah, tell me. who knew that everything is possible. Everything in this world. Gem of a person. If you have not read his books, read it. Winds of Fire, The Young Minds. There are many, many series of books. I'm a very fortunate, I will say, young old man who met him, had a cup of coffee with him when he was the scientific advisor to the Prime Minister. My sense of telling you this is poverty, economic poverty, is a blessing. Nobody helps you? Fantastic. You go and try that. Don't help me. I'm in the poverty. Because you make me realize that I alone can do things. I am born here to conquer the world. When the nature created me in the mother's womb, you were not there with me. Hence, I don't need you. Yes, I need to go on. You agree with me?
Yes.
You agree? Why do you say, sir, she said this, that woman did this, that woman did this, my brother did it, my sister did it? All this is just wasting your time. Bullu, 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 come on. Life is not meant for what you thought. In life, there are many things happen. One of the greatest things that happen is, somebody would have gone the left side of the road, somebody would have gone the right side, somebody on the straight path, somebody on the back one, and somebody didn't go anywhere, stood there. Everybody has their footprint. Everybody has their footprint in their life. And these footprints unravel some great secrets, which is not written in or printed in any books. One has to dig into those footprints while Abdul Kalam went to this side. Because he was a refused engineering seat. Thanks God, refused. Thanks God, he was not accepted as a pilot. He became the boss of the entire Indian Army Force. See, you deprived him of one pilot, he became the head of the Army Force. The President of India is the commander in chief of my entire Army Force. Navy, Army, and everything. Everything was at his disposal. Challenges. When the challenge comes, you raise the location. When the toughest situation comes in front of you, the tough will start getting going. Otherwise, generally, everybody can tell you, kuch nahi hota, nothing will happen in life. I am born to suffer. I am born to fail in my exam. I am only going to get 40 marks. Whatever anybody says, because God doesn't like me, my friends don't like me, my parents don't like me. This is idiotic. This is ridiculous. This is pessimism. Don't have even such friend around you who talks this language. You need to talk to a language that I can. Why not I can? It's me alone. I can do wonders. If somebody can do it with that part of the world, why not I here? All it requires is a very simple thing. Many have walked through this place. Nowhere it is written in any books. The great secret that is hidden in these footprints. Abdul Kalam is a footprint. Swami Vivekananda is a footprint. There are great scholars. Lal Bahadur Shastri is a great footprint. Mr. Kurian is a great footprint. Swami Nathan is a great footprint. What about the agriculture revolution? What about the milk revolution? What about the scientific revolution? And one made the whole human psychology in the world over come together. The language of brotherhood, which you do every day, they are all Indians and my brother and sister. Against you are limited. Why all Indians? Why not all the citizens of the world? So Vivekananda went and told them that look, brother and sisters, everything sorted out. The language that you speak will come only from the confidence you have in yourself and your life. You do not underestimate yourself as A for apple. Don't underestimate yourself as B person died. How it happened? 456 years back, on a full moon day, a young boy was seen from the top of the hill where his house is. He was seeing moon very close. He thought, is it not possible for me to jump on the moon? This idea started working on his mind. It is the idea that makes a difference to the person who discovers thing. Simple idea came into his mind that can I jump and reach moon? He was just working on that in his mind. Then one day he saw his mother taking rice in that soup bowl. She does the rice like this. The rice goes up and falls like this. Goes up and falls. Then she picks up the small stones, removes it and cleans it like that. So he observed her closely. He said, yes, so I must have some feathers like bird. Then only I can reach there. So he takes those two supas and ties up here. And one fine day on the full moon day, he goes up and jumps and dies. That was the first human being who made it possible for Neil Armstrong to reach the moon. Neil Armstrong was not great. That man who first died. That is the man who got the first blow of life, that reaching moon requires some intellectual ability to probe, investigate and move forward. He had the belief in himself that he is doing the right thing. You may say, he's an idiot who died. No, no one is an idiot. Human body does not never produce the idiot. Idiot is our only intellectual limitations that we do not see things beyond a point. We do not perceive that what can be done. We always see what cannot be. I have a very different set of mind, not like others. I do not believe in any competition with anybody. You are not competing with each other. This is all foolish things we do in life. Why do you compete? What is necessary for competing? What will happen if you compete with each other? You will only reduce yourself to their levels. Supposing I just imagine that I am the best speaker in the world, then my limits go high. If I think that I am a speaker who have to impress the 30, 40 people I meet tomorrow at one X place, then what my entire mindset will come down to 30, 40. Competition is never with any other individual human being. Whoever competed with the other human being, he has achieved nothing in life. A person who achieves anything, he is a person who has got to the unlimited situation. The infinity. That is why people say, I am Merko Kyada and Mere Santo Bhagavan. God is with me. Why do you say? Because he doesn't take anybody's help. He is only interested in what he is doing, focusing. Concentrating. Concentration is something that you have to develop in your belief system itself. That you just saying that I believe myself, I am very confident that nothing will happen. You got to practice what you believe. So my condition with you is compete, fix a benchmark. How do you do that? Suppose nowadays girls are playing cricket, boys are also playing cricket. They also go to the World Cup, we also go to the World Cup. You also play hockey, they also play hockey. You also play shuttle badminton, of course boys are nowhere in shuttle badminton in the world. They are not visible. There are only one guy from Karnataka, Prakash Padukone. After that we had to learn a competition from other people. These are the two guys and after that everybody disappeared. Both became coach, one produced the great Sanya Nehwal and PV Sindhu and others are vanished. In a country of 127 crores, we do not believe that practice alone can make a man successful. The benchmark of success is not the parameters fixed by Pulley or Bobichan, it is by what you fix for yourself. If suppose you have a shuttle racket in your hand and you are practicing with the ball and you don't allow the ball to fall, you go on doing that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and there is nobody to support you, take a soft ball. There is a soft ball. You can use the same racket and you can use the ball and go on hitting without allowing the ball to fall. You start all backhand first. Continue daily 2 hours backhand. You come and play with your friends, you'll find none of them are standing with you. Just with one stroke, they go away. Because they never practice. They are illusory thinking that they can play well, but you are practicing. And you should never become arrogant. When you are playing with a person of a below practicing level, then you should not become arrogant. You'll say, TK, I will play one more game. And be sporty, you played well, yeah. Today it was my day, that's it. But never say that I knew, I am a great player. That means you have limited yourself to that standard. By defeating a person who is just not even played the what you call school shuttle badminton tournament, if you compete with him, you can never become an international number one. Practice. Belief in yourself should not develop those all points. It should develop those points which will add strength to you. So, practice in life what you have learned. And one day you find that your practice has made you superior, especially when you have the keyboard in your hand. You got to practice. It's going to do a riyaz both there. Riyaz karna pata hai. You got to do. You cannot say, I learned music just because you are a bathroom singer. In fact, Muhammad Rafi was afraid of me because I was singing so well in the bathroom. But then Muhammad Rafi was nobody. I used to have a lot of clothes waiting for me to be beaten by my parents, my children, all the youth around me. But he said, bathroom is just a matter of time. Anything you require, practice alone can make you perfect. And please don't mind perfection in this world. Don't go the foolishness of mind perfection. Perfection is God. The human can transit to Godhood, but you've got to be somebody greater than greater, like any Elias or Moses or any great saint. You've got to be somebody like Swami Vivekananda, you've got to be like Krishna or somebody. You have to reach that extreme level of understanding the divinity. You, otherwise you cannot. Why do you waste your time? You fix your target on your performance of your life. Today I performed in 90 marks, tomorrow I have to do 91. I was referring to the first principal, you will remember that our days, the education was very different. What was our education those days? They were never used to give full marks for the exact textbook copy. You buy heart and you copy, never used to give. How they used to give marks? There is a mistake, no problem. But has the boy constructed the sentence on his own or not? Has he understood or not? Has the girl understood or not what the subject is? One of the greatest of the poems is that Robert Frost, Snowy Evening. Miles to go before you sleep. Miles to go before you sleep. What was that movie at that time? That was the poem it used to tell the significance that human desires are not. Human desires are not. And one has to sacrifice many desires to fulfill one. So that was the direction it gave. So my sincere advice to you is, it is your day. This life is yours. There is no one to support you. Whatever God wants to give you, He has given you in the form of eyes, hands, legs, brain, everything. Set the process to use this brain. You've got to change yourself. You've got to think different. I do not have time today. I don't mind coming back again and walking with you. Sometimes, principal sir thinks that we can still have some more time. Then I can go on and I can show you many movies also, short films also, that's how actually the nature functions with human. I got about 750 films stored from different places in the world, including British Broadcasting Corporation. And there is one movie I bought. I just told you the small story and at 9:30 I mentioned, I think 2-3 minutes I still have. There is a tribe in Africa. This is the smartest tribe in the world. What they do, you know? They make lion hunt food for lions. Lions have to go and hunt. And they bring a big catch. Maybe they caught a big deer or a zebra. And the deer opened and wanted to eat it. And then they tried. Three people. Just they see the lion eating the food and they walk towards the lion. What happens, you know? Lion runs away out of fear and these people cut the meat, take it and go away. The entire operation they are doing hardly 1 or 2 minutes. By the time, hidden behind the vision, the lawyer is understanding that they were deceived. They thought these 3 people are coming to kill them. And some people, the very, So life is not about covers. Those who fear lizards, cockroaches, many of you fear, many of you also, that walks in the wall, that believe. Come out of all these things. Accept yourself. Understand yourself that you are a unique personality that exists nowhere in the world. You are the best. There is nothing better than you. Take up a task. Work on the task. Checking up the task. Keep periodical review and move forward. That's it, is life. Thank you very much for giving me this time. I can go on for some more time, but I need at least 2 hours to conclude and entire subject that brings. So thank you very much, children. Hope you enjoyed it. My concluding remark, without the slaves in the country, we cannot do. So then with me, Bharat Mata Ki.
Thank you. We know You have given us your precious time, and it is worth giving us to listen to you, the words of wisdom, your wonderful words. And at this age, you have really made an impact in my life, in the life of our students, and they will take it for their life in order to be motivated and also to believe in themselves. You have widened their horizons. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you all.